Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV Online, Shadowbringers Edition. This is episode 72 of Beetlejuice Detailjuice Volume 4, currently at 1:38 in the PM on July 28th, 2023. And, you're a Final Fantasy XIV fan? Sorry, I'm a little bit out of breath. Let me catch my breath. If you're a Final Fantasy XIV fan, you're staying far away from this stream as it is being streamed, because FanFest just started a half hour ago, and everybody's finding out about all the Dawn Trails spoilers and shit, but the new job, and well, maybe there's a new job, I don't know. I didn't stick around after the intro video, because they're about to get started talking about the story of the expansion, and I do not want any spoilers to it. Maybe I'll read a little bit about it before it comes out. But that's just not coming out for like a year. And I haven't even started 6.1 yet. And so, that's why I'm streaming. Doing my own thing. Nobody's going to stop by unless they know me. IRL, that kind of thing, maybe. That'd be cool. But, we'll see what happens. Anyway, but Dawn Trail, Summer 2024. No spoilers. Let's begin. Actually, I gotta change my chat overlay. Okay. Now we may begin. I just beat the Vol 3. I did the dungeon. Did the trial. For some reason I didn't want to stream it. Now I'm in the mood to stream, so here we go. Got one of those situations where a bunch of cutscenes are gonna play. But, like, make sure you set it aside enough time. But we've got all the time in the world. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe I'm gonna die tomorrow, maybe the world's gonna end tomorrow. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe time is gonna get compressed by Ultimecia and we really will have all the time in the world. One split second. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about anymore, so let's just... exciting... shit. I've got a couple of texts coming in. Sorry.
That I am a god. is why I was born. As man and sin eater both. I kept the people safe. They respected me. Worshipped me. How can this be? I should be the one looking down at you.
Look, the sky.
Fools! Were it not for my decisive action, the whole city would have been overrun, razed to the ground. Yet they dare to complain about casualties? Spare me. I'll wager they were put up to it by those wretches who seek to usurp me. They're stirring up the citizenry. But if they think I will yield to the likes of them, they are gravely mistaken.
To be subjected to such deplorable treatment, such ingratitude. You have my sympathies, sir. You do so much good for this city, and you could do so much more were you not surrounded by fools.
Who are you? You're not supposed to be in here.
My apologies for the intrusion, but I come bearing a proposal, one that will ensure the longevity of your reign. But give me the word, sir, and I will bring hither a Light Warden. By giving its power to the babe within your lady wife's womb, we shall create a transcendent being, a king to rule over all. And as sire to the king, your authority will never again be in question.
Amazing. Before my Vorthry, they behave as docile pets. With this gift, my line shall be guaranteed power for perpetuity. We shall rule the whole world.
By all means, sir. United under Yulmore's banner, men will cease fighting and abandon their ambitions. Thus, they will grow fat and complacent, and in their sloth, seal your supremacy.
Are you all right? Say something. Twelve for Fend. He cannot contain the light. He's beginning to turn. Orange, if you've aught up your sleeve, now is the time. It's changing back.
Every Light Warden is too terrible a burden for any one soul to bear.
And
so I shall relieve you of it.
Exarch, what are you doing?
Channel this profusion of power to the Crystal Tower and use it to travel to other worlds. As I have dreamed of doing ever since I first learned of their existence. Who would choose to remain here in this dying realm when they might go elsewhere and begin anew? Not I. And thus did I use you.
I don't believe you! It doesn't make sense! Damn you! We won't let you do with him as you please!
Do not interfere! Please, I beseech you all, let him go!
You knew of this, Urianger. It is all a fiction. Such vaguely defined acts of teleportation stand no chance of success.
Okay.
The Exarch will never live to see another world, as he knows only too well.
Oh.
Then, what does he mean to do?
He means to take the light with him into the rift, where he will die. From the beginning, he intended to sacrifice himself to save our friend and Norvrent.
At Journey's End, an opportunistic thief makes off with the hero's prize. A paltry way to end a chapter. I concede. Yet your tale will continue, and my role in it will scarcely be remembered. Worry not. Whatever should become of me, I will be happy and free, safe in the knowledge that I have played my part.
Oh my god, it's him! I can't believe I'm forgetting his name.
thank you for fighting for this world, for believing. Fare you well, my friend, my inspiration.
You're the meaning in my life. You're the inspiration. You're meaning to my life. And I know. Yeah, that's what that was.
Only those who possess the royal eye of the Alagaan Imperial line are capable of controlling the Crystal Tower. Such individuals do not exist in the First. Therefore, in all likelihood, the Exarch arrived here with the Tower. This much I had surmised, yet I could not discern his grand scheme. Think that he went through all this trouble for the sake of a single hero. It's almost admirable in its absurdity. Alas, it is not your grand scheme that will succeed, but ours.
You bastard!
Stay put. Your friend is still alive, but whether he remains so depends on you. What a disappointment you turned out to be. I placed my faith in you, let myself believe that you could contain the light. But look at you now, halfway to becoming a monster. You are unworthy of my patronage. My heart's sole desire is to usher in the great rejoining. 100 years ago, I entrusted my comrade Logriff with the task of increasing light's sway over this world. This we sought to do by manipulating heroes. When that failed to achieve the desired result, I created Vorthry. Thanks to your meddling, that, too, has ended in failure.
What was your true purpose in approaching us?
By your 12, boy, have I not told you before that everything I said was the truth? You were specimens by which I might gauge man's potential as it stands. I genuinely had an interest in you, genuinely considered taking you on as allies. Provided he could contain and control the light. If not, then he, and by extension you, would be of no use to me. 'Twas as simple as that.
So, we've been found wanting. How disheartening. But even had we fulfilled your conditions, there was no guarantee that we would cooperate. What then?
Then I simply kill you all. At the very least, it would restore the world to the way it was before you went about trouncing Lightwardens willy-nilly. Suffice it to say, it would be most inconvenient to have all that light taken away, and I would be lying if I were to claim his actions didn't have me worried. Still retain your form and your senses, but you have all but become a sin-eater. Whether you will it or no, your mere existence will serve to engulf the world in light.
No.
Those in your company will likewise turn into sin-eaters, And in time, you will succumb to your base instincts and hunt innocents to feast on their sweet, sweet ether.
Wrong, motherfucker.
Those few the will left to fight may rise up against you. But before your absolute might, they will quickly know despair. There is no hope. We are finished. Mankind is finished. Ah, the irony. What Forthry achieved through bliss, you achieved through despair. But I have overstayed my welcome. I shall look forward to seeing you bring the world to its knees, hero. Exarch! I have naught to show for all the time and effort I invested in you. He is a small token for my troubles. I did not expect that I could learn aught from man, but I may yet learn something from all the knowledge he had hoarded for his precious hero. I pity you, I do. Your friends are now your foes. If you do not kill them, they will kill you. When it all becomes too much to bear, seek me out at my abode in the dark depths of the Tempest.
There,
you may complete your descent into madness with some dignity, far from prying eyes.
Till then, I bid you farewell. Eat it.
After you collapsed, Emmett Selk vanished. Then Rhene did what she could to stay the raging of the light within your body. Thanks to her, you're still you, but she's only delayed the inevitable. You're not going to like what you see, but you still need to see it. Like this all over. The whole of Norvrat is shrouded in light again. And it's because of you and the power you absorb from the Wardens. No one knows but your friends, When they carried you down from the mountain, they told everyone waiting below that they didn't understand why the light had returned. And now they're out there trying to allay the people's fears while searching for a way to save you. If you're well enough to be up, you're well enough to get some fresh air. Better that than stewing in here. Go on. Go.
Level 80? Burden of Light, let's check. Key of Innocence. Well, you know what? I think it's time for me to see you. Buy some armor. Or wait, can I, do I have to wait for that? Have to buy some from the tomes here, but I could buy some shit off the auction house. Sometimes you run into ridiculous deals. Oh. Already had a bunch of shit. Need a damn boot. Thank you. feeling much stronger today. chaos.
Thank you.
time you hear that lawnmower out there. Look, yeah, my two battles back to back. Come on. Thank you. guys, well, that is the end of this episode, I think. In the next one, we'll have lots of adventures and it'll be a fun time. Thanks for watching. Bye!